What's that?
In the morning?
Isn't that what you do?
Yes.
Are you not a guy from the hospital?
Mike, John, this is me.
I keep hearing people talk about getting different beers. Some people were trying to compare and try to say, oh, no, not that guy. Someone that wears glasses.
Hey, Bear, pass me the mop real quick. I'm gonna dry mop real quick.
Oh,
you're doing that.
You're doing a lot of like.
That's a prime pick on it, you know?
I
good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When's your catcher coming?
I don't know if he has Fridays or Sundays.
Sundays are sacred days for people. Sundays are sacred days for people.
To come in?
Yeah.
Sunday they don't like work, training.
Yeah. Sundays are the best days for me, bro.
Oh, these days are super fun.
Oh, everyone here?
Oh, everybody.
Good, bro. We're going to see how it's going to be today. I think it's going to be pretty bad. Always is.
Thank you.
Chevron starts now.
Pitbull's Globalization Channel 13.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm I just wanted to make this clear. Yeah, I saw the video on Twitter. It's like the
9,500.
Yeah.
I don't think I've won. I lost today.
So what you did is you played defense, right? Come on. on your phone that you're fat. Okay.
I'm going to go to the restaurant.
I threw my arms out.
I was waiting. I was like, I'm gonna go to sleep. But his arms are gonna burn out. It was choking.
Thank you.
The 91.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I like to put my head in my belly, head in the chest, head in the armpit, and like, I'll pass your hands around. I'm not necessarily doing anything, but like, I'm making you like, oh, 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 while it's heavy.
I like this one.
I think you're strong enough pressure.
I like the sternum, sometimes it's awkward, you know?
Yeah.
I don't like doing that, like, working south, like, because, you know, I'm pretty sure it's not.
Yeah. The hitch can't come up. Right. I call that, yeah. I wrestled for a long time. I wrestled on the wrestling team. Folk style.
I just really like half motion, like rolling over.
I mean, you should check out some wrestling classes, though. It would be very intuitive for you. Like go on like high school wrestling.
Yeah, exactly.
Top and bottom basics, yeah.
Basics, yeah.
Because once you know the concept of how to keep people down and things like that, you know, you just start applying different techniques.
Dude, there's this one, I forgot what it was, somebody taught me. But dude, I was teaching it in jiu-jitsu. And setting like using it and setting up like jiu-jitsu like moves and stuff, you know? And I remember the wrestler that showed it to me. I was like hitting it on those things.
Like a three-quarter and stuff or
like,
like one of my grand brothers high school was which is jiu-jitsu is called twister. So I'd leg in and I'd leg right, I'd go banana split. What's that? In wrestling, yeah. That's why they call it twister, because wrestling has the
jiu-jitsu is a dirty team, but banana split is still banana split. There's no calf. No calf like on that.
There is like pressure points that you can use, like you shit against the calf and stuff, but you're not allowed to pick their calf up or do anything like, you know, apply pressure against their stuff, you know?
Yeah.
You're good at defending the arms around the neck. A lot of people want to come back. Anyway, like even that thing you're doing, when you're pulling me down, I'm really good at pulling myself back up and staying here.
Oh, yeah. No, dude, you know, try right there, bro. Like, I had to do it. Like, if I was off just a little bit more, you would have fucking got your arm up.
Yeah, I was gonna impress that.
That's one of my favorite moves right there. Right.
Everybody does it to me, bro, and I'm able to, like flip on. Hey, I felt it coming.
I'm trying to sweep the other way. I do watch that, can we?
So I'll try to do that, right? So, like, same, like, right here. Like, my main goal is, like, jiu-jitsu, like, even me. I'm always trying to get this. Like, it didn't go out right here. Or what was the other one we were just talking about?
The one where you grab my arm.
Oh, yeah. So there's that one. So I try to get this one. And then sometimes they might try to, like, hug around. But when they hug around,
my main goal in jiu-jitsu is to stay on top. So like every time I roll in here, the only thing I'm thinking about is like, I want to be on top of you.
Were you trying to do a box choke at one point?
Ezekiel.
Ezekiel?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, box.
Okay.
And Logi?
Okay.
But yeah, Ezekiel.
Yeah, the Nogi one is right here. I do that often. I get from standing.
It might be called Ezekiel. There's so many names. I got tapped out like that one of my teammates.
Hey, I'm actually super surprised you're able to keep me off of that, bro. I forced a lot of people into that position.
Yeah, I thought you were going to hit me. I would have been good.
Hey, honestly, after an Ezekiel tap, I usually get wrist locked, you know, heel hook or something, some crazy, you know. I'm like, oh, okay.
I love wrist
lock. The good thing about wrist locks for me is they don't hurt me.
Yeah.
You know, it's my ankles or like start snatching those up. Alright, got it.
Yeah, I
want to
catch.
Yeah, I had them like turn my wrist all the way this way, come up and try to do all that. It doesn't hurt. You know what does hurt? It's this one. That one hurts and loves hurt. I don't know why, but this one doesn't. This one hurts, bro. Like, I can't tap fast enough.
Tap hard.
Yeah, tap hard.
He was like the enemy of this. His hands were like all that.
Every day, except for Sunday. And then Mondays and Wednesdays, I go to a fight studio.
Upland,
11 a.m.
Yeah.
No, it was Manka or something like that. It was, but now it's just Lucas.
Lucas with
that? Yeah. Hey bro, but everything he's been going over lately has been wrestling. Yeah, I'm like, bro, I'm coming here for some fucking jiu-jitsu, man. Seriously, bro, it's all been like stuff that I'm very familiar with, you know? So like, I've been kind of buttered. The only redeeming factor, bro, is that there's like 5 black belts. That's me, I get the shit out of it. So far just Lucas and his wife, Tati, or whatever, Tata.
They've been like super fun.
Yeah.
They used to come and train with us.
It's cool as fuck, bro.
What's up, man?
So, bro, how you doing, man?
Pretty good.
Cool.
Get some rolls, man.
I'm rolling.
Really?
Yeah.
Shapes our culture. The music is in the air and trembling. If you know the undercurrent,
sounds and the ideas that went into the sound, and when you can feel its weight, it becomes more meaningful. I'm Hanif Abdurraqib, a poet and culture critic, and I'll be your guide as you seek to teach you.
And you're chill, you know?
Right, yeah, I'm a little chill until, like, my face starts to get right away.
Look, it hurts, dude!
I'm going to take a visit.
pounds. I thought he was like 10 pounds. I weighed him.
They warned you.
Huh?
They warned you.
Hell yeah. He says he went, he was not in the grid. Jonathan, he's doing the tournament, so watch out. Nah, I'm joking.
Yeah. Thank you.
That's what I heard, bro. You're in your fucking house, man. Hell yeah.
Come share
that? Okay. You're not passing.
Come on, Sunday, right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.